Go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. No matter who you are, strength is an essential element that everyone needs in their life. For overcoming problems and difficulties, and we can do all things through strength. Philippians chapter 4, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, Ephesians chapter 3, and Colossians 1 prove us that we are strengthened according to God's will, not our own. And my main verse is Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, and I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. This passage is taken out from Philippians chapter 4, and this book, Philippians, is a really interesting book. And this verse is talking about we may not be able to do anything we want, but we are able to do everything that Christ desires and plans us to do. And this passage is written by Paul, the apostle. It's written to the church Philippi, especially to Timothy, Epaphroditus, and Eurodia. And Philippians is talking about the Christian life of the gospel. And Paul was in prison when he was writing this book. And my first cross reference is 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. No matter what is standing in your way, there's no way to stop the power of God. And no matter how weak you are, when His plan comes past, we can overcome everything that He wants us to do. And don't be ashamed of weakness that we have, and be able to use God, and God will use them to strengthen us. And my second cross reference is Ephesians chapter 3, verse 16. He may grant you to be strengthened with power through His Spirit in your inner being. This verse shows us that we are strengthened through the God's will, and the power of God is where the strength comes from. And we can be able to do all things through Christ, and in order to strengthen His way. According to the Bible, the strength comes from the love of Jesus, and we can have the abilities to do everything through it. And Ephesians chapter 3, verse 16 is a great verse for supporting when the church Colossae was weak. God spoke through Paul to comfort them, so as now we can use the word to comfort people with those words. And my third cross-reference is Colossians chapter 1, verse 11. May you be strengthened with all power according to His glorious might, for all endurance and patience with joy. At that time, the church was being persecuted. And Paul was praying to God that to strengthen us with patience and joy. And Paul was telling the church to give thanks to God from taking out from spiritual darkness, which is the power of Satan. And we are strengthened with God's will, not our own. And furthermore, we should not doubt the gifts God has given us, and we should use them. And I'm going to talk about the story of Gideon. Gideon was a guy who doubts his own abilities and suffering from failures and defeats. And there's one day, God showed up and tell him to lead the army to fight against the Midianites. And the Midianites are the descendants of Midian, and their religion and political system are really close to the Midianites. And so they like to fight against Israel, and they live in the northwestern Arabian Peninsula. So as the handout that I showed you guys, there's like more information about them. And the picture is about what the situation during that time is. And God proved Gideon by showing him like a basket of meat and water in it, and they were on fire and disappeared. And God was trying to help Gideon to learn how to trust Him and have faith in God. And Gideon's army has 300 men, and Midianites started with 3,000 men, which is impossible for Gideon. But God uses miracles to help Gideon to confuse the enemy by making it appear that Israelite army was huge compared to them. And in their confusion, Midianites fell within their own army and killed themselves. The one that didn't got captured or escaped or killed by the men, or killed by the Gideon's army. And they won against the battle. And this story told us that we do not have to start as strong men, but we can still be able to do everything through Christ. And I'm going to show you a video of Gideon's story.
It's still loading.
Yeah.
I don't know, do you think if you press play it'll go or no?
I don't know you. The Lord wants you to save his people.
But that's really not possible. I'm only a boy.
The Lord wants you. Only you, Gideon.
I don't believe you. Give me a sign that God sent you.
Look at that basket there on the ground, Gideon.
Why? Why? What do you want to do, huh?
Look at the basket there on the ground and pay attention. Now you'll see what the Lord can do.
Such miracles.
Gideon, it's the Lord, come on.
In conclusion, we can do all things through strength, and we're really weak without strength. And we don't have to start as a strong man and a healthy man, but we just do be able to do all things through strength. Philippians 4, 2 Corinthians 12, Ephesians chapter 3, Colossians 1, proof is that we are strengthened according to God's will, not our own desire, and we can do all things through strength. No matter who you are, Christian or non-Christian, strength is something really that you need in your life to solve problems and difficulties. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much.